Before we go to NGS, right? Is there any question related to extraction?
Yes, I have some question. So because like the step of the sample collection, do we have any seal to frozen the sample before we can bring the sample from the field to the lab? Like it may be far away from the lab, so it takes like 2 or 3 days. So the Qiagen, do you have any seal to any kit for sealing the sample?
Okay. Actually, if we transport sample for 2 or 3 days, you can use pore protect. You can use pore protect, or if you don't want to purchase any reagent, you can utilize dry ice and make it frozen. So you can deliver or transport the sample for 2 or 3 days.
So this one is not the DNA RNA or extraction. So yes, this is raw sample, this the stone sample.
Yes.
How about the blood sample?
Same.
Okay.
Same.
How about the water, like very low biomass, also the same. We apply the power rotate.
Yep.
Okay.
It is same.
Okay, thank you. So and then my second question concerning about the blood, when we had a home blood, or we use the serum, or we use plasma, or we use the bifocals to extract the DNA form, which one is the best for microbiome?
Sorry, can you repeat it? Can you repeat
so
it?
I just want to know that we had the home blood, and then we also have the serum or plasma or bifocals. And then I don't know that should we extract the DNA from the plasma or from the home blood, which one is the best to make the balancing of the bias?
Okay, it depends. If you the target is a virus, if your target is tfDNA, you have to separate first by a red blood cell and the plasma. So you have to promptly after the collection, you have to promptly separate it, red blood cell and plasma. Take it the plasma and extraction. But if you want to study with human DNA or RNA, you can use whole blood. You can use whole blood.
Oh, over here, I mean, I get concerned about the DNA of the bacteria.
Oh, okay. Oh, it means, yeah. So when you talk about bacteria, no way bacteria will reside in plasma. They will reside in whole blood. So you just have to use whole blood for bacteria extraction.
Okay, it means that we will extract the total DNA.
Yeah, correct. Yeah.
Okay, not from the serum or plasma or bifocals. Okay.
Yes, correct.
Okay. Even we do for microbiome, not for human.
Yep, correct.
Okay.
Correct.
Okay.
Because if you separate plasma and use the plasma, bacteria cannot reside in plasma, because bacteria is more condensed, more compact. They will involve in a red blood cell pellet. You know what I mean? So the plasma cannot contain the bacteria.
Okay. And then for the blood sample, should we deplete the hot DNA before after the DNA purification test?
Sorry?
So can you come back the slide of the deplete the host DNA?
Okay, wait.
Yes, over here. So we do the DNA extraction for the total RNA, and then we do this step or verification, and then we remove the host DNA.
Oh
Which
no.
step?
Yeah, actually this is this method is you based accord what the principle is you have to separate you have to lyse the host cell first and degrade the DNA has. After that you degrade the DNA has and eliminate it, and after that you lyse the microbiome or a target cell and isolate the DNA or RNA. So it can be done after all the gDNA host depletion cannot be done after all you get total DNA or RNA. So it's this workflow have to be done at the first step.
Okay. So in this slide, you propose four methods for remove the DNA host. In my case, we want to do the microbiome on the blood sample. So which methods is the best? We want to do for the bacteria and the fungi. We don't do for virus. So which one is the best methods here?
For the liquid biopsy, right? For liquid biopsy for the blood is the best in you use benzonase for DNA host removal, and you can use buffer lysis. What Qiagen have is I think buffer EHL. As I mentioned you before, so it's strong enough for host cell and weak enough for microbe cell. So the buffer lysis will lysis a host cell first, and after that we use another buffer lysis that strong enough for microbiome cell.
Thank you. And then my last question concerning about can you please give me the report for the microbiome bioinformatics analyst? The last slide you showed that you also have the map, the bioinformatics pipeline for analyze the microbiome. So that's one is for 16S or for the shotgun, the subway, do in both or only?
This is from 16S. This is from 16S.
I mean your software, can you go back into your software? The map
Sorry.
software. Yes, one more
Software,
please.
software. Here.
The bioinformatic, yes, over
Ah.
here, the map, you see?
Yeah.
The
Yep, yep,
map,
yep.
yeah. So I just curious about the report. Output from the bioinformatics analyst. So, do you have any report about it?
For any report, right? Wait a minute, yeah. I
So,
think I will. Yeah,
you can
I will
send me
send
later.
you the file. I will send you the file and example of this report after this. Right.
So, and
So
then.
give me, yeah, give me, just give me your email, right?
So, the pipeline is for both the 16S targeting Amplicon as well as the shotgun, is it?
Yeah,
For both?
correct. Correct. Correct.
Perfect. Okay.
6 and S.
Okay, thank you. So, Mời cô Diệp, please.
Good evening. I'm online late because I just missed the time. So I have two questions. The first one is that if we would like to transport the DNA sample abroad, it may take several days. So is it necessary to put the DNA on ice or just put in room temperature is okay?
We talk about blood or sample other sample type?
I I mean that DNA extraction.
Oh, DNA. Oh, okay.
Yeah,
Okay. Extracted
the
DNA, right? Okay. Okay.
DNA already extracted from the bacteria.
For abroad, right? For abroad,
Yeah.
we cannot predict what happened in during the journey, right? So
Yeah.
I suggest you to put the sample in dry ice. Put the
Okay.
sample in dry ice. Don't you cannot put in the ice. So because ice pack or cooling pack, it's retain only few hours after, and if in another day the temperature in the environment of the temple will be much higher, so it will affect the DNA or RNA in the sample. So I think you have to consider use dry ice if we talk about abroad transportation.
Okay, thank you. And my second question is that I extract bacterial DNA for the NGS. So how do you think, in which solution I should store my DNA? In the elution buffer from the Kaizen kit, or just in distilled water without the RNAs and DNAs? It means distilled water. So in which
Okay.
solution, in your experience? Thank you.
Yeah. Actually, if we have if you use a commercial kit, right, in at the end result, DNA or RNA extract sample, RNase enzyme or DNase enzyme, I think it's completely removed. So the matter is you have to consider to use elution buffer that contain elution buffer with molecular grade, right? That contain less EDTA, less EDTA. If you want to continue to NGS, because EDTA will much affect to amplification process in NGS. So if I suggest you in Kaizen, as far I remember, buffer AVE is the best is best choice for NGS.
You mean in distilled water or in the elution buffer from
Elution
Kaizen?
buffer. Elution buffer.
Elution buffer is better, right?
Yeah, correct. Correct. But be careful, because some kit of Kaizen, for example, if you use KM then Amini kit, they use buffer AE. Let me buffer AE, and the kind of the buffer is high is has high EDTA, so it does it not suitable for NGS method. So I suggest you to search another buffer like AVA buffer. I will text in the chat buffer AVA here.
Okay,
You can
okay.
See my chat. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
yeah.
you.
So we still have one question from Michelle. Michelle asking that they any Kaizen kit for the DNA extraction from stone, urine, and FFPE for long read like orthogonal sequencing.
Yeah, okay. For long read, yeah, it it's an issue in an hot issue, right? Because many country has the market of nano ONT nanopore is increasing. So in long read, we need DNA high molecular weight DNA. So we only can utilize a certain kit. In Kaizen, we have MagAttract make a track HMW kit. Make a track HMW kit. Or you can use magnetic bait kit, because basically magnetic bait kit can provide more fragment DNA above 50 kb kilobase DNA compared to mini columns, silica mini column. Silica mini column is doesn't suitable for long read NGS. So you have to purchase Megatrack HMW kit from Qijun or other other brand that can give high molecular weight DNA readout. And we have a dedicated kit for stool, urine, or FAPA. And directly removing, of course, yes. Qiem DNA microbiome kit is one of the example of our kit can do host depletion or DNA human host depletion. Yeah. Wait a minute. Okay, this is our dedicated kit for stool, Qiem Power Fecal Pro, and DNEZ Power Soil Pro for the soil sample. But this is not only for stool or soil. Actually, basically, if we encounter sample within a lot of inhibitor, we can modify the protocol that reside in this kit. So actually, the two kit can utilize for sample that contain high inhibitor and high nucleosa. And for the yes, this is for the host depletion. We have Qiem DNA microbiome kit.
Okay. Thank you, Nadan.
Okay. Is there any question? I will continue to NGS.
So I have one more question concerning about the low bias. Low biomass sample, like some water or some skin microbiome. Yeah, and then.
Yep.
There any suggestion for the Qiem kit or any kit that help to increasing or enrichment? Do we need to do the WGI whole genome amplification or we don't have to?
Okay. There are some ways. I think there are two ways to increase the concentration of DNA or RNA from low biomass sample. First, we can concentrate the microorganism. For example, if we use wastewater, right? Wastewater sample, we can use pore, micropore. We can use it. We can concentrate it from the wastewater, and after that we can extract the cell from the micropore and do extraction process. And after that, if the result is still not good, we can use amplification of genome DNA by using reagent. If in Qiagen we have it, the name is Replig. The Replig this refugee can multiply and amplify genome DNA or other microorganism DNA. We can get so far what I see, this compound, this region can give a better result in NGS at the end.
So my contact is we know about newborn sepsis, so we cannot collect a lot of blood from the baby. So so that reason that we don't know that which one is the best methods, because like we only have like around 1 to 2 milliliter. So milliliter.
What DNA target you want? CFDNA or a human normal?
No.
DNA?
We want to do the sepsis.
Okay. Yeah.
For the baby, the newborn baby.
Yeah. You can use Replici. You can use Replici.
Okay. Can you please type down into the chat box, please?
Okay. Yeah. Is there any question from this part?
Thank you, Nanda.
Yeah.
Any question, please? So because like our audience today, only interested in the microbiome analysis, so we just want to know about the THN product that have any label frame kit for the microbiome with the shotgun or 16S, the target one. Do we have any specific kit for it?
Yeah. For the microbiome, for the metagenomic study related to microbiome diversity, right? We have several methods. We can do whole genome sequencing, and targeted sequencing. For whole genome sequencing, we can sequence all DNA or all DNA of the microorganism in the sample, and for the target sequencing same, but it's more cheaper. Let me show you. I think I have okay. Here. So it depend on your purpose, right? If you want to NGS, do NGS for the microbiome, there are two methods we can use, is whole genome sequencing or shotgun sequencing, or you can use 16S rRNA or ITS targeted sequencing. If you want to, if you want to microbiome diversity on a species level, you can use 16S panel, 16S or ITS panel. But if you want to, if you want to get microbiome diversity in a strain level, it's a highest taxonomy, right? It's a deep taxonomy strain. You cannot use 16S panel, but you can use whole genome sequencing or shotgun sequencing instead. But for the whole genome sequencing, we have limitation. For multiplexing, maybe we just can run one sample per run. But if you want to run more sample, you have to choose 16S instead. For the 6 and S, we will sequence variable region V1 to V9. We have panel for this. Okay. So it depends your need, strain level or only species level.
Yeah. How about in the case that we really want to do the metagenomic include the 16S of bacteria, also the fungi ITS, as well as the eukaryote with you the 18S, as well as the virus that come from the RNA virus, because you have the kit that can extract multi-model include DNA and RNA. And my question is, like, do we need to do the cDNA to convert the RNA extraction into cDNA, and then we mark the DNA from the bacteria and also as well as the fungi, and then we do the sequencing with the cDNA?
Yeah, okay. Actually, for the extraction kit, right, for multimodal, we have all prep DNA. All prep DNA, wait a minute. For the extraction kit, we have all prep DNA or RNA mini kit. So we can extract all kind of the microorganism, bacteria, viruses, that the RNA viruses, DNA viruses, and yeast, alga, more. And for the NGS kit, unfortunately, for these Ki-seq multimodal panels, yes, they can sequence DNA, RNA simultaneously, but the panel only for oncology, not for microbiome. But we can modify some protocol so you can simultaneously a sequence from bacteria, yeast, alga, and the virus in one run. We can modify it.
Mm-hmm.
We can.
So
we
don't need to do the RT-PCR to do the cDNA. We don't have to.
Sorry.
With the NGS kit over there, we don't have to do the PCR to do the cDNA convert them from the RNA to the cDNA.
Yeah, still need. Still need.
Okay.
If that our target is RNA, right? We still need convert RNA to cDNA.
The point is we have a mixture of both DNA from the bacteria fungi,
yeah,
as well as the RNA from the virus. So if we do the cDNA and then we have like bias, we create a lot of dominant of the RNA, from the PCR, RT-PCR.
Yeah. That's why this reaction will have to separate. So that's why we have to first we have to do extraction with all prep DNA RNA, so it will separate DNA or RNA material genetic. So DNA, you don't have to do RT-PCR, RT reverse transcriptase, and in RNA result you can do it. You can do it. So it's not there's no false result here.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And then I just worry about the bioinformatic analysis. So we cannot have the abundant analysis because we already have the bias of the RT-PCR to. It's okay. We still have more to go. So.
Yeah.
Mời cô Diệp, dạ.
Cảm ơn thầy Lợi. I just would like to ask a question. I think that the Kiagen kit is quite good. However, we have to use additional like mixture or rupture machine to break down the cell membrane. For example, if we want to extract DNA from gram-positive bacteria, so just using Kiagen kit is not enough. Sometimes we have to use very strong special mixture to disrupt the cell wall.
So,
So what about your opinion, or is there any kit, strong kit, so that we don't need to use the mixture because it's quite expensive?
May I know what kit you usually use for the
I
type
use
of
the Kiagen bacteriemia DNA extraction.
reagent?
We extract the DNA from bacteria directly from blood without isolation and without culture. Directly when the bacteria when the blood sample culture positive from bacteria, we just take out the blood and we just extract DNA directly from the blood. So when we use just the Kiagen, the bacteriemia or some name like that, so it form, we cannot extract DNA. And when we have to use the mixture, like rotator is very strong machine. It's not like it's kind I don't know, but actually we use like a mixture for PCR, like vortexing or something. Is not help. It doesn't help. We have to use the mixture, like a rupture machine, is very strong, automatically with high speed. So it help. Actually, I don't remember exactly the name of the kit, but the kit is for extraction DNA from blood sample. With the, I think the patient have sepsis. And they culture positive blood sample, positive, but they didn't know which bacteria yet. So just positive, and we take it out, and we would like to whole genome sequencing. Okay, thank you.
I see. I'm not sure. For the bacteria, the problem is when in the sample, we have gram-positive bacteria, right? Because bacteria, gram-positive bacteria is much tough papillomavirus. So there are special treatment, and you can use bead mills, beads like a glass bead, okay, glass bead, and an alternative. The alternative way, you can use enzyme lysozyme. So if we can call the extraction kit is for the bead, for the wait a minute there yeah, for the for the beads, the technology is reside in KM than a microbiome kit. But yes, for the bead technology, the glass bead technology, it will work for gram, not only gram positive but gram negative. But there are additional instrument. It's like a kind of vortex. So you said about rotor, right? Rotor with high speed. Is it correct?
Actually, we use hula mixer.
Oh, mix. What is it? I don't know it. I don't know
It's
it. But
from In Vitrogen,
oh, okay,
Thermo Fisher.
automatic. But in KM Denmark Microbank, we don't need we don't need expensive additional instrument. We can replace it by vortex. So you just give a glass bit in the I think here in this here degradation law here in here you have to put in the vortex and keep remain in the vortex for 5 minutes.
Yeah, actually, we also use Bit Raptor Elite from Omni International. I don't know, Omni is which company, but actually, we have the machine from Omni, OMNI International, and in like Bit Raptor Elite. Yeah, so actually it works sometimes, some very special gram positive sometimes. Yeah, it's a curve. Okay, so thank you for your suggestion. Thank you.
You can use enzyme like lysozyme as alternative, right? So
okay.
I think it's more
lysozyme for gram positive, you mean?
Yep, correct.
Okay.
They can lysis gram positive by lysozyme.
Okay.
So
thank you.
You can use KIM DNA kit and purchase additional lysozyme. So in the handbook, you can find dedicated protocol for gram positive by using KIM DNA kit. But
okay.
if you don't find lysozyme, I suggest you using KIM DNA microbiome kit because there's no need enzyme, there's no need additional reagent, and it can extract DNA or RNA from gram-positive bacteria and negative bacteria, and can deplete DNA host cell.
Okay.
So that's the advantage.
Okay. Thank you.
So there is one more question. Can you estimate the time from the extraction to the library preparation before the sequencing?
Oh, library preparation, right? It depends. If you talk about whole genome sequencing, right? Wait a minute. If you talk If you talk about whole genome sequencing, we have QIAseq FX DNA library kit. By using this kit, only takes around 2 hours, and if we combine to DNA extraction, it will be around 4 hours. So from the end, from the DNA extraction, start from DNA extraction to library preparation, it will take around 4 to 5 hours if whole genome sequencing. But if you do hybrid sequencing, if you do targeted sequencing or hybrid sequencing, it will take around 2 or 3 days, around 2 or 3 days.
Okay,
for the example here, it's the workflow of hybrid sequencing. It will take around, more than one day.
Okay, thank you. So then, so Mr. Dang asking that, can the UMI adapter totally replace the primers for the PCR?
Sorry? UMI?
Can the UMI adapter totally replace the primers for the PCR?
UMI, wait a minute, yeah. I don't get it, but you...
Yes, I
so
also
here,
don't.
here. UMI is the sequence for what unique molecular index. So this is can avoid of false result. It's and the sequence, this kind of sequence can avoid the false result, and it can replace primer, because there are no primer will complementary to this. The couple the primer, the sequencing primer will only attach in adapter session, adapter near adapter session, around here and around here, but not in UMI. So at the full complete the library in the in the NGS instrument, in the sequencing instrument, the primer sequencing will attach here and do amplification. And if you ask about a primer for amplification region of interest, we talk about single primer extension and specific primer region here. For the single primer extension, we only have one unique primer for a specific region and one universal that can attach in the adapter here.
Yeah, thank you. And then for me, like the question is like asking very different. So Rimer is designed to with different purpose compared to the UMI. Yeah. So and then there is one question asking that do we need to concentrate the DNA after we do the extraction before the library preparation or not?
Okay. Yes. For the to increase or concentrate the DNA or RNA, right? We have some ways. One of the ways is using refriging, and after that we can use SpeedFac. Do you know SpeedFac? It's like concentrator. I think in laboratory, molecular laboratory, they have it. So SpeedFac, it can evaporate dilution, so the analyte will stay in the bottom of the tube, and we can, after that we can add dilution with a lower volume, so it will concentrate the DNA or RNA.
Okay, thank you. So in short, we need to do the concentrate of the DNA before do the library preparation. Okay.
Yeah. Because each kit has requirement for DNA input, so you have to calculate what the minimum of DNA or RNA concentration you have to generate from extraction.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Have any more questions, please? So Wang, are you happy with the answer from Nadan? Wang? Okay. So if there are no question, please join me. Thank you so much, Nadan, that give very nice lecture to us. Very helpful information. Thanks a lot, Nadan.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. Yeah, you can contact me by email or WhatsApp number if you find if you encounter the problem with your purification or disruption process. You can directly WhatsApp me or text me by email. Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Okay, can you copy your email and then put in the chat box, please?
Okay.
Yeah.
There any additional question I see here?
Yes, you,
oh,
miss
biosecurity.
It.
Oh, okay. Wait a minute. Okay.
Okay, thank
Yeah.
you. Sorry, I will speak Vietnamese, please. Không biết là bên Phương Đông có công ty Phương Đông có phát biểu gì thêm trước khi kết thúc hôm em.
Dạ, bên em cũng cảm ơn anh Lợi đã dành thời gian cũng như là tạo cơ hội cho anh em mình có bài trình bày của về về các giải pháp tách chiết đấy của bên em tới những người nghe ngày hôm nay ạ. Thì nếu mà bên mình vẫn còn câu hỏi nào nữa hoặc là muốn tìm hiểu thêm về các cái quy trình hay như là cũng như là các cái công nghệ mà bên em cung cấp ấy, thì lát nữa ở cuối buổi em xin phép em để lại cái email của em ở trong phần chat ấy, thì mọi người có thể gửi cho em. Thì nếu mà có những câu hỏi nào em trả lời luôn thì em sẽ gửi lại, còn nếu không thì em sẽ tư vấn với cả các bạn đại diện phía bên hãng rồi sau đấy thì gửi lại cho mọi người thông tin ạ.
Em để lại contact của em đi với một số bạn ở đây nữa đi em ha. Đó, tôi nghĩ là sẽ có rất nhiều anh chị em hứng thú muốn biết đó mấy cái kit nào để làm microbiome đó, thì nó đa dạng lắm mọi người, có người làm đất, có người làm nước, có người làm rễ cây, có người làm lá cây, đúng không, làm microbiome mà rất đa dạng. Bởi vậy là rất cần sự tư vấn của bên nhà phân phối Kiagen, đây là công ty Phương Đông à, đó thì mong là tụi em để lại contact ở đây để anh chị em nào có nhu cầu nó sẽ có cơ hội để biết hỏi ở đâu cho nó phù hợp à.
Dạ vâng ạ.
Cảm ơn công ty rất là nhiều đã mời anh Nadan ở đây tới để báo cáo. Tôi biết được là tiếng Anh thì mình cũng hơi khó đó, bởi vậy là cũng xin bên Phương Đông xin anh Nadan có cái slide á để gửi cho mọi người để có gì mọi người về xem lại đó, cũng chưa có tiêu hóa được đâu tại nó nhiều quá đúng không, đó trong 1 tiếng rưỡi đồng hồ thì không thể nào mà tiêu hóa hết được. Bởi vì nếu mà có slide thì anh chị em ở đây sẽ dễ dàng xem lại và có câu hỏi sẽ gỡ lại sau à, có contact của bên chỗ của Phương Đông và contact của anh Nadan ha. Rồi một lần nữa cảm ơn công ty Phương Đông, cảm ơn Nadan. Thanks a lot Nadan, thank you so much for your time, we learn a
Yeah,
lot
you're
from you,
welcome.
thank you so much.
Yeah.